Rank Math has got an easy mode to benefit beginners who want to let us do all the heavy lifting SEO work following the best practices. But we also have an advanced mode for users who wish to have full control over the website's SEO. Many options are available only when you enable the advanced mode in Rank Math. Hi, I'm Kate. In this tutorial, I'll walk you through how to switch from easy mode to advanced mode and give an overview of the features you can customize in Rank Math's advanced mode. To switch modes, open Rank Math's dashboard and click on the mode that you wish to use on the top right corner of the screen. You can also choose a mode while you set up the plugin in the Setup Wizard. To access the Setup Wizard, open Rank Math's dashboard and click on the third tab. In advanced mode, Rank Math's dashboard will show more modules. You don't necessarily need to be in advanced mode to use the options from the modules, so you can just activate them and return to easy mode. We will cover this later in the video. Let's start with the 404 monitor, which gives you an overview of your entire website's 404 page not found errors. To learn all about monitoring and fixing 404 errors, watch the video that's on the card. ACF module helps to analyze the content that is written in extra fields, besides the text area that were created with the Advanced Custom Fields plugin. The Role Manager lets you restrict individual features for each user depending on what roles you provide them on a website. The BB Press module adds proper meta tags to your forum posts, categories, profiles, and more, created with the BB Press plugin. If you use the Buddy Press plugins to manage forums on your website, activate the Buddy Press module to add proper meta tags to all forum pages. Image SEO module adds a new tab to Rank Math's general settings with options to automatically add the alternative text and title tags. Pro users also have options related to image captions, descriptions, and more. The Redirections module is what allows you to easily redirect your URLs with just a few clicks. Click on the card to learn all about redirections in Rank Math. The last module you can activate and deactivate in the advanced mode is the Schema or Structured Data module. This will add options in the titles and meta settings, as we will see later, but for Rank Math Pro users, it also creates a schema template section where you can create custom schema types for your content. Now, let's see the options only available in the advanced mode. Rank Math's general settings gained several new tabs, and some tabs have more options. The first tab, Links, gains options besides the original Open External Links and New tab. Strip Category Base, Redirect Attachments, Redirect Orphan Attachments, No Follow External Links, No Follow Image File Links, and Affiliate Link Prefix. A new tab will appear with the breadcrumbs options. You can learn all about them with the video tutorial that's on this video's description. The next new tab allows you to edit the robots.txt file. We have a video tutorial about that. The link is also in the description. Then, there's the option to edit the htaccess file. If the Image SEO, 404 Monitor, or Redirections modules are active, the settings for them will appear in the general settings even after you switch back to easy mode. In Titles and Meta, several tabs have more fields. The Global Meta tab will show settings for the Advanced Robots Meta tags, and the option No Index Empty Category and Tag Archives. You will also be able to set a standard thumbnail for when your post is shared on social networks that use Open Graph protocol, such as Facebook, Instagram, WhatsApp, and LinkedIn. Then, you can define which type of Twitter card will be used automatically when posts are shared there. You can change both of these settings for individual posts in the Social tab of Rank Math's Meta Box. We made a video explaining how. Click on the card to watch it. The Local SEO tab will also have settings for email, a physical address, opening hours, a phone number, price range, setting about and contact pages, as well as a Google Maps API key and geo-coordinates. With Rank Math Pro, you can have all of these settings for multiple locations. The Homepage tab, which is used when the website's page displays the latest posts, gains several options. You can customize the robot's meta tags and set a title, description, and thumbnail specifically for Facebook and for other social networks that use Open Graph. The Authors tab will display options once you enable author archives, starting with a field to add a term base in the URLs of author archive pages. You will also be able to customize the robot's meta and advanced robot's meta tags for author archives, as well as set the default variables for title and description. Finally, there's an option to add SEO meta box for user profile pages, which can be tuned with code. The Miscellaneous Pages tab also has several more options. First, customizing the date archives meta tags, including the title and description. You will also be able to set a title for the 404 error page and the search results. There are also options to add the no index meta tag to search results, paginated pages, archive subpages, and pages protected with passwords. When the schema module is active, the tabs for all of the post types will have the option Schema Type to set a default that can be changed in the Schema tab of RankMath's meta box. If you're using Advanced Mode, under that option there will be new fields, like Headline and Description, which will depend on the type of schema that you choose for that post type. The Posts tab has the settings for the default Robots Meta and Advanced Robots Meta tags, suggestion for links to other posts and if those suggestions should come with the suggested post's title or keyword, which taxonomy will be the primary for posts and appear in breadcrumbs in case you use them. To add RankMath's SEO meta box to the editing page so you can customize these settings individually. If bulk editing for posts, for instance, to add robots meta tags, will be allowed. And which custom fields would be analyzed with the main text for RankMath's SEO score. Custom post types, such as products, will have settings for default SEO title and description, as well as the title and description for their respective archive pages. Other settings will be just like in the posts. The tabs for taxonomies, for instance, categories and tags, will be related to their archive pages. You can set the default Robots Meta and Advanced Robots Meta tags using variables for title and description. There's also an option to add an SEO meta box where you can change the default individually. For instance, no indexing one particular category, even though category archive pages are set to be indexed. And finally, remove snippet data, which removes schema data from the taxonomy's archive pages. From the sitemap settings, the options only available in the advanced mode will also vary according to the tabs. The first tab, General, starts with links per sitemap that limits the amount of URLs in each page. Having more control over the number of links per sitemap benefits performance. The following two options exclude specific posts and taxonomies, including custom taxonomies, by submitting their IDs. An ID is a number assigned to each post, page, or taxonomy, and you'll find it in the URL when you open it in the editor. For any post type, it's the number right after post equals. For taxonomies, it will be the number right after ID equals. The last setting in the General tab, Ping Search Engines, tells RankMath to notify Google and Bing when you update a sitemap. Tabs for any post type, including attachments and custom post types created by third-party plugins, have one extra option in the advanced mode. It's called Image Custom Fields, and it's useful when you add images using custom fields instead of inserting them in your content the traditional way. If you want those images to be indexed like any other in the page, add the name of that custom field. Tabs for taxonomies, including custom taxonomies, also have an extra option. It's called Include Empty Terms, and it means that even archive pages that don't have any posts in them would be included in the sitemap. You should reconsider including empty pages in the sitemap, as they are only excluded by default because they hold thin content. The SEO Analysis module has 21 tests in the simple mode. In the advanced mode, it includes performance and security categories with a total of 29 tests. You can check out all of the tests on the video that's on the card. The Status and Tools section gains 3 new tabs in addition to System Status, which contains information about your website. The first is Version Control, where you can roll back to previous versions, enable beta versions, and set up automatic updates for RankMath. If you want to learn how to use these options, watch the video that's on the card. Database Tools has several options to delete the data if you want to start fresh, or if you're running out of space in the server. Finally, Import and Export has 4 options. First, you can copy RankMath settings between different sites. Second, if you switch from another SEO plugin, RankMath manages your settings for a seamless transition. Third is an option to create a backup before making substantial changes. RankMath Pro users have an extra option, importing and exporting SEO metadata for posts, terms, and users from a CSV file. You can learn how to edit your posts at scale watching the video that's in the description. If this tutorial helped you, give it a like. If you have any questions, click on the link in the description to open a free support ticket. You can find more tutorials in our knowledge base at rankmath.com/KB.